Faster than a speeding bullet? Not quite. But these planes will go from New York to London in less than 3 hours. Until 2003, elite travelers, people who really did live in the fast lane, could book a seat on a Concorde jet at a top speed of Mach 2.04, or about 2,170 kilometers per hour. A Concorde aircraft set the world record for the fastest commercial flight across the Atlantic. It took the jet 2 hours, 52 minutes, and 59 seconds to make the journey. But economic woes forced the fleet into retirement. We've been stuck with subsonic commercial aircraft ever since. But that may soon change. Everyone from startup companies to NASA is interested in bringing supersonic travel back. This time, things will be different. First, let's get to grips with what supersonic means. Technically, it means faster than the speed of sound, but that's a little vague. The speed of sound depends upon the medium through which it travels. Even the temperature or humidity in the air can affect sound speed. When engineers talk about the speed of sound, they typically mean how fast sound travels through dry air that's 20 degrees Celsius at sea level. That speed is 1,235 kilometers an hour, or Mach 1. Most commercial aircraft cruise at speeds closer to 885 kilometers an hour, well under the sound barrier. When an object travels faster than the speed of sound, it generates a shockwave in the air. The solid object forces air out of its way in a cone that moves outward and behind the object. This cone represents an extremely rapid increase in pressure, which is released almost immediately afterward as the object passes. That release causes the thunderous noise we call a sonic boom. The bigger and heavier the object, the more substantial the boom. That boom travels with the aircraft. If you could teleport just in front of the jet over and over, you'd hear the boom each time it passed overhead. Along with the economical issues facing Concorde, this was a big drawback. A supersonic jet makes a terrible racket, but the supersonic commercial jets of the future may not be as loud. NASA and Lockheed are working to create what they're calling Quiet Supersonic Technology, or QUEST for short. Cute, right? NASA wants the finalized aircraft to create not a thunderous boom, but a more quiet heartbeat-like noise. NASA engineers also want to limit the environmental impact of the aircraft, so no gas guzzlers are allowed. They hope to have a working aircraft in the early 2020s. Meanwhile, a startup company called Boom is also trying to bring supersonic flight back. Boom's plan is to operate planes that can seat around 50 passengers. The company has already revealed a smaller prototype aircraft called the XB-1, nicknamed Baby Boom. The top speed for the proposed commercial aircraft is Mach 2.2, or 2,335 kilometers an hour. But traveling at that fast pace will mean paying a hefty price. The company says it plans on pricing flights similar to traveling business class internationally, so that's about $5,000 to $10,000. Personally, I'm excited about the advances we'll see in aeronautics and engineering as a result of these projects. Aircraft designs will become more efficient and require less thrust to maintain lift by necessity. And those improvements in aircraft design will find their way into other vehicles, even ones that aren't meant to travel at blistering speeds. So even if someone like me can't afford a ticket on a super fast flight, I may still see the benefits of all that work in a lower ticket price for a slightly more leisurely airplane ride. What do you guys think? Would you pony up the cash if it meant getting to your destination much faster? Let me know in the comments below. And thanks to Toyota for sponsoring this show and making it possible. If you've enjoyed this episode, give the video a like and subscribe to the channel to join the forward-thinking think tank. And to see more about the future that could be, check out these videos right over here.